1, 2, 3, 4. Hello. Aren't you adorable? There's our little furry creatures. Oh, there's two underneath there.
Cute.
So there is. Six. It would be nice if the little opossum would show up, yeah. But this is later than it was yesterday, but that's whoop. Okay, what spooked you guys?
Yeah, is that the possum coming?
I don't think so. They can't usually hear the possum coming because it's...
That's sneaky.
Well, I think it comes out from underneath the shed.
Ah.
So...
Well, this is dropping out of the tree.
Yeah.
That's so weird.
Unless it's raining possums.
Yeah. I saw that tree branch shaking, and I was like, now I know the wind's not blowing that out in that one spot. And then I saw it. Yeah.
And it did catch on the video.
Oh,
you couldn't
cool.
see it real clear, but you could see something fall.
Cool.
Yes, my little raccoons. You are so cute. Yes, my little star kitty. Yes, you are a sweetie. Mm-hmm. In spite of yourself sometimes. Especially when you decide you have a hairball.
Oh, no.
Coughing up gunk all over the house.
That's always fun.
Hello. Yes, come on out. Yes, have a drink. You are a cutie. Yeah. Yes, we do love watching our raccoons. The raccoon whisperer and his lady are getting married.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
So they have to get married fairly quickly because she can't immigrate until they get married.
Oh.
And she's from Georgia.
Oh, okay.
And of course,
online.
Well, initially, a friend of hers told her about his YouTube.
Okay.
And so she started watching, and she loved it. Not too surprising. A lot of people did. And so she wrote to him, or actually, initially, she didn't write to him. She sent him a care package for the raccoons.
Oh, okay.
You know, goodies for the raccoons and some treats for the kitties. And then in the second or third time she sent a goodies for the raccoons, she put her phone number in the box. And so he called her.
Oh, my goodness.
And so they've been talking on the phone for like a year and a half.
Oh, wow.
You know, got to the point where they were talking pretty much every day. Then this summer, she got to come up and they just hit it off like a house on fire.
That's cool.
Yeah. And so she had to go back home because her mother was ailing and her mother's passed on.
Oh, okay.
And now she's back and they got engaged and they're going to get married. And they're, it's not like they're spring chickens or anything, you know. They're both grandparents.
That's so cool.
Yeah. And she's a, she designs computer things for video stuff and video chats and things.
Yeah.
And so, and she has two cats and he has two cats, so they'll have to bring up the cats, but none of that can happen until they get married,
right?
Yeah. So they're going to get married fairly quickly.
Yeah.
And then of course you have the usual trolls. She's just after you for your money.
Oh,
he's going, I hate to tell them this, but you have more money than I do.
That's funny. Good for him.
I really hate to bring this up.
That's funny.
But they make each other laugh.
That's good.
Which is, you know,
that's important.
Very important, especially, you know, they're older now, and yeah. You know, he's been widowed for 19 years.
Oh,
and,
wow.
You know,
that's a long time.
Yeah. It was his second wife. His first wife divorced him, and his second wife, she died after they'd been married for 2 years.
Oh, wow.
But the reason he feeds the raccoons is because she asked him not to let them, you know, you'll keep feeding the raccoons. So he said, okay. And 20 years later, he's still feeding the raccoons. And his mother-in-law lived with him for 10 years before she passed on. Oh. So he took care of her.
He must be a really good guy.
Yeah. No, so, and fed the raccoons.
His hands full, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway.
So if he's, you know, if they make each other laugh and he's happy with her, more power to them, you know.
That's good.
It's like, wow, let's go on. So I'm going to send them a happy wedding card.
Oh, that would be nice.
I'd kind of like to send them a present, but I have no idea what they could possibly need. You know, it's like, Angie was saying, no, we have to bring the cats up, and that's going to be a pill.
Oh, dear.
Moving them from one country to another.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so.
Oh, look.
Hello, little possum. And she's going, I have to figure out what I'm going to do with the house I just had built.
Oh, no.
In Georgia. Come on, little possum.
Or their winter getaway.
But this weekend, they have to deal with the hurricane. That's about to hit Nova Scotia.
I don't remember ever hearing one going that high.
It doesn't happen often, but every now and then, you know, it'll. Usually, if they get anything, it's just the tail end of it, but looks like this one's going to be hitting them with like 120 mile hour winds.
Oh,
so, I see your little footers. I see those little footies. Yes, I do. Come on, baby. Oh, you found the stash of sunflower seeds. Yes. You are so cute. Even when I can only see little bits of you. Come on out.
Enjoying those sunflower seeds.
I wonder if it's the same one that came out yesterday. If I could get a look at his ears, I could tell.
Hmm.
The one yesterday, the ears were all black.
Oh, really?
So if it's got little white spots, it's the other one.
Oh.
Yes, you are such a puss. You with the little motor. Come on, baby. Come on out. Are so cute. That's it. Picked lettuce off my little lettuce bushes to go with our dinner tonight.
Oh, good.
Yeah. We had Korean dumplings.
Sounds good.
Kind of like pot stickers, but they're from Korea, so they don't call them that. So they're Korean dumplings.
That's funny. Pot stickers are good.
They were really good.
Mm-hmm.
I made like a lettuce wrap with my little lettuce leaf in it.
Oh, cute.
And of course, rice.
Yeah.
That's one little gadget that we got that we have used and used and used.
Yeah, that's
the little rice cooker. Yeah. I've eaten more rice since getting that rice cooker.
Mm-hmm. I love rice. Keith doesn't like it so much.
Well, I tried using brown rice for a while, but
it's not that good, is it?
It's just not what I want. Yeah. So we'll do white rice.
Well, Adam, I finally opened that bag of chicken nuggets I got from Costco. Yeah. And he would not even try them. Okay, I know they look just a little bit different, but they're still chicken nuggets and they still taste good. Because I ate one. Go ahead, try it. Just try it. He would not. Mm. He refused. So I guess we'll take him to church or something.
If it's not my chicken nugget, I don't want it.
That's like him and the Lay's. His teacher was telling me that she tried sticking some Pringles potato chips in between his Lay's chips, and he ate around them. He would not eat them. For some reason, he will not eat Pringles. And I don't know how he tells the difference then. He likes the Lay's. He won't eat anything else. He does like the Poppables. Those are pretty good.
Well, that's one of those things with the, you know, with the autism. It's a hyper sensitivity.
Yeah.
You know, there's no filters, and that's why they're, you know, because there's no way to filter things, and so they, I guess they know when something is slightly different.
Yeah.
It's not the same. I don't want it.
Yeah. Well, he had a substitute bus driver, and he refused to get on the bus. Mm-hmm. And even when they got the old bus driver back, he still wouldn't get on the bus.
Mm.
So he rides home with me now. He rides to school in the morning fine on the bus, but he won't ride it in the afternoon. Mm.
Like, well, it's one of those minor little problems.
Yeah. Well, the new bus driver didn't pull up in the same spot where the old bus driver did, and I think that was the first thing that upset him. And then it was a different person. But then when they got the regular bus driver back, he wouldn't.
Already changed, yeah.
Did I tell you what he did? Casey sat down with him and went over his spelling words, and then he had a little book that they had copied that she was going to read with him, and she started reading. I think she read two pages to him, and he was so done. He hugged her where her head was turned away from the book, and while he was hugging her like this, he was turning the pages on the book till he got to where it said the end, and then he let go of her. And he went like this to the book. He tapped it where it said the end, and he put his finger on it where it said the end, and then he pointed to his phone. That was hilarious.
Not stupid.
Yeah, exactly. Like, okay, you sneaky boy. I guess if you're done, you can have your phone back.
I'm done now.
That was so funny.
Yeah, when we first moved down to Tempe from Flagstaff, and the school that Jason was going to go to was a mile away, and I tried to get them to pick him up on the bus.
Yeah.
And they said, nope, you have to be on the other side of the road for him to kind of going.
What?
He's hyperactive and attention deficit.
Yeah,
he is not walking a mile to school.
No.
He won't make it.
Yeah.
Well, he's young and strong, he'll make it. No, he won't make it because he'd lose concentration before it.
Right.
And he'd be gone. He'd stop and pet a dog or a kitty cat or, you know.
It's a car.
Yeah.
Well, look at that. Just a butterfly.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I went round and round with them for like the first month. And yet the same guy as last night. Hi there. Aren't you adorable? And said, well, he's getting to school just fine. I said, of course he is. I'm driving him.
Oh, yeah.
I work nights. I stay up until I drive him to school.
Oh, goodness.
You know. Yeah, it was.
Wow.
So,
did they find you letting him ride the bus?
Nope.
Really?
They wouldn't even let him walk over to where another disabled kid was going to be. So we don't do that for ADHD kids.
Oh.
Excuse me?
That's terrible.
So I drove him to school every day for while he was in, third, fourth, and fifth grade, because that is, the only way to make sure that he got to school, and then Eric would come and get out of high school and walk down and pick him up and walk him home. But it's like, no. So,
When I was in high school, the high school was at the bottom of the hill, and the elementary school was at the top of the hill. It wasn't that big of a hill, but the kids that lived in front of the school, just at the bottom of the hill, they rode the bus. I was like, what are you doing? Why are they riding the bus? It's just like, they can walk there in a minute. They rode the bus. That's great.
And when he went to the junior high, he could walk to school because it wasn't that far. Mm-hmm. And he was a little older and he was taking his meds. Yeah, but you know what? You are not the same one. Even though your ears are all black, your feet are also all black.
Mm-hmm.
Well, except for your toes. But you are a cutie pie. Yes, I love seeing you. Yes, I do.
Well, sure, it's straight, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes, you can stare at me all you want. But yeah, it's sometimes I wonder about school.
Yeah, well, I know.
It's just, no. Yes, you are just the cutest little thing.
We have a new kindergarten teacher this year, and she's young. I mean, I had her when she was in middle school, when I was in the library. And but she has so many good ideas, and she works with them. She has them every morning, stand up, and they say, I am smart, I am loved, I am...
Oh, good.
She goes through, but it's really cool.
Basic affirmation.
Yeah, and she's more positive driven than the other two teachers, and I just think she's doing such a great job.
Oh, good.
And the kids in her class are just thriving, and she makes it fun to be at school.
That's good.
And I think that's really important.
Yeah. I did really well in kindergarten and first grade, and then second grade the teacher bored me silly and I was gone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hi. And Jason did fairly well in kindergarten and first grade because the teachers accepted him for what he was. And dealt with him the way you have to with a hyperactive attention deficit child. And his, kindergarten was no big deal. Lots of playing, But first grade, teacher went through the first semester and she said, it's not getting better.
Oh, yeah.
So I took him to the doctor and said, for some strange reason, teacher seems to think he's ADHD. My doctor looked at him and looked at me and said, this comes as a surprise to you. I went, no.
That's funny.
He's been ADHD since he was born. basically. He slept for the first 2 weeks because he was preemie, and then, not a lot, but, mm-hmm. And then he started bouncing and hasn't stopped. So, yeah, no. We had to have a playpen for Jason. We never had one for Eric. It was the only way to contain him. Yes, you are so cute, and I've been filming for 20 minutes now, and you're about to wander away, so I'm going to let you get a drink. There you go. Bye-bye. Yes, you're very cute.